I love it when our first guest is here. He makes me laugh. Please welcome my friend, Dax Shepard.
As you can see, I did not practice waving.
That deserves $30,000. Yeah. We've been partnering with Ulta all month long, raising money for breast cancer research, and so every magnificent entrance is so far, I think you've made the most money.
Can I tell you, my fragile male ego?
Yep.
Is so upset that I crashed.
Well,
I'm having the hardest time shifting gears back into being here.
Really?
That almost destroyed me.
Well,
I might drink over this.
You don't drink.
No, I don't drink.
Don't make this the one.
But I did wave and I did lose control, as you saw. But
yes.
I think I recovered. The loop was good, right?
It was wonderful.
Okay, thank you.
Yes.
I've always had a Shriner's fantasy. This fulfilled like my Shriner's fantasy.
Yeah.
You see them in the little cars with the gigantic poobah hats.
That seems, because I know you know how to ride a motorcycle.
Yes.
And you have children. Did they have little tiny motorcycles like this?
Well, it's funny you would ask that, because my wife was in Hurricane Irma. What people don't know is that Kristen was supposed to be shooting a movie. She got evacuated for 2 weeks to Orlando. She stayed at Disney World. She was with young cast members. When I would call her at 10 a.m., she was intoxicated at Disney World riding Avatar. She was on spring break. And every hour someone called me panicked if she was okay.
Right.
This brat was on spring break.
It sounds like she was not,
so
yes.
I kind of wanted to get even with her. So I had the kids by myself for 4 weeks. So in that time, I bought my 4-year-old an electric motorcycle and
Lincoln?
Taught her to ride it. Lincoln, yes. She's 4 years old and she's this big. She can ride. Look at her. Come on. Come on. Around the barrel. Oh.
Wow.
That makes me happier than anything.
Wait, how many times had she been on before?
Never. That's day one on the motorcycle. She rode for 3 hours, never crashed. She just did that in circles. And I think she, like, 40% for her and 60% for me.
Wow.
I was, like, going bananas.
That's amazing, and she must love that.
She digs it. Again, she likes how much I dig it.
Yeah.
Yeah, because I'm very vocal about my approval.
Oh, my God.
She's riding that thing. So Kristen got home. Well, first, I sent her this video, and she goes, oh, my God, what? You taught her to ride a motorcycle. And I go, yeah, it's fine. Look, she didn't crash. Everything's good.
Yeah.
And she got home, and I had left the box for it in the recycling bin, and it said on there 13 and over. So I was in kind of hot water for a minute.
Yeah,
should
have taken that one off.
Just three.
Three and over.
Three and over. Yeah. She's almost a year too late.
You've been married 4 years now?
Yeah, together 10 years, married for 4 years.
Married 4 years. And because y'all waited for it to be legal for everyone, which I love that you did that. That was great.
Our pleasure.
So I saw something that she posted something or sent something to you?
She texts me completely out of the blue. She was at work and I get a text. Do we have a prenup? And I'm like, that's a very disconcerting text to receive.
Yeah.
So I posted it and I said, this doesn't seem like a good text to get, does it?
Not around an anniversary, no.
No.
Ever, really.
You just don't, why would someone be wondering if you have a prenup?
Yeah,
they're either gonna kill you or leave you.
Right.
Yeah, yeah. It's not like, I'm gonna buy him flowers, do we have a prenup?
Right, no, no.
That's not the line of thinking. So
no.
As it turns out, which is funny, she doesn't know that we don't have one. But when we met, I had a lot more money than her, and I'm crazy about money. And as we were leading up to getting married, she said, "Hun, would you want to get a prenup? Would that make you feel better?" And in my head, I was like, "Yes, please."
Yeah.
And then I said, "No, I do not want a prenup." She has since made way more money than me.
Uh-huh.
And I'm a genius.
Yeah.
I got in at the basement floor. I like signed LeBron James on a playground in elementary school.